Latrice with Sterling Law Offices, and today I'm interviewing Katie Rasul from Team Awesome Coaching. And the reason why I'm wanting to interview her today is because she offers our clients something that we all need when we're doing a major transition, which is some guidance on helping us to get to our next level. So, Katie, welcome.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
And I know some people aren't quite familiar about what coaching is. So could you kind of just give us a summary of what it is that you do?
Sure. Well, as a coach, you know, sometimes that word can be kind of confusing. And we might interchangeably use it sometimes out in the world with consulting or mentoring or advising, and it's a little bit different from that. So as a coach, what I do is work one-on-one or even in group settings within organizations with clients to, you know, find out what it is that they are really wanting to accomplish and then help them get there in a way through asking empowering questions, very question-based, and always keeping the client's agenda. So whatever it is that you are trying to accomplish, we hold that true, but help find the ways and unlock some doors on how to get there. Where it's different from something like consulting or advising, that's more of the type of work where it's say, well, here's what you should do, or here's my advice or recommendation. And that's never going to be the case really with a true professional coaching model. It's going to be more about me asking empowering questions about what's important to you, keeping that safe space so that we can have some of those conversations, and maybe it's something you haven't ever discussed with someone else, but then holding you accountable to the goal that you want to set for yourself. So it's a great way to move forward, move through a transition more quickly, or hit goals more quickly than sometimes we can on our own, because sometimes we tend to get in our own way as human beings. So that's what coaching can really offer, is the support, the guidance, and the accountability.
And that's awesome. I think a lot of our clients, our model here is that we're here to help families move forward, and coaching is one of the ways to do it. I know I have experienced some hesitation in the past by some clients to use therapy because they don't feel like they need a diagnosis or need to speak about what they're feeling. They just need someone to help them identify where they want to go next. So coaching is an awesome tool for it. Now, I know you have a certification from the ICF, and I know what that means, but could you kind of explain what that certification is and what it means?
Sure. So I completed about a little over nine months, pretty intensive training program to become a certified professional coach. And so one of the things that was really important for me, because my education and making sure that I knew some best practices were important for me as a coach. And it's still an unregulated industry, so not everyone has received a certification, or they might be different certifications that you're looking at. So my recommendation, and certainly the type of training that I've done through that program, is completed a training program that was an ICF-accredited program. And the ICF is the International Coach Federation, so they're really the governing body around the ethics of coaching, the principles of good coaching, and a professional model, so that we stay true to what coaching should be versus advising or consulting or some of these other types of practices. So the certification is important because, you know, anyone who has gone through that lengthy of a program or a program certified by the ICF, that they are definitely putting the time to learn a lot of skills. The other thing that I think is really important about that, and was vital for me, is that I experienced a lot of coaching and a lot of my own personal transformation. And sometimes as coaches, I think we can only take our clients as deep in the internal work as we have gone or understood. And so to have that transformative in my own experience is really important and makes me a better coach.
That's awesome. I wholeheartedly agree about how impactful having been through coaching yourself, it probably relates to your own practice of it. Now, What type of clients are you, do you typically help?
Yeah, I generally focus on both individual clients and then if I'm doing group or individuals within organizations on people who are your professionals or in leadership roles in particular or roles of influence. And so all of my clients are very bright, driven, successful people that are looking to still move through a transition or move on to their next steps or attain goals more quickly. So I do have individual coaching clients, and then I do work with organizations or leadership teams within organizations as well to help them find their best life and their best leadership model. And I coach, you know, really focus on the whole person. So it's not like we only talk about work or we only talk about home. You know, you're the same person whether you're going to your job or you're coming home to your family. And so a lot of those things really tend to overlap and make a difference when we talk about them collectively.
Right, and things that are going on in your personal life, you know, we all, if I'm having a bad day, it doesn't just stop the second I walk into my office, unfortunately. And so it's great that you're looking at everything holistically, trying to see what's really going on and helping guide clients through it. Now, I don't think most people know kind of how coaching is offered as far as like packages or sessions. How do you, can you describe your packages or sessions?
Sure. Everybody is a little bit different. So when you look at different coaches, certainly there you'll see some variation in what they offer. How I structure my coaching is I have a couple of different packages just depending on how many sessions that you're looking for each month. So your 2, 3, or 4 sessions. And what that means is the frequency of how often we get to meet, you know, for our session, but also matters in kind of how quickly you're moving towards your goal as well with some of that. One of the things that is unique to my packages as well is that I am a master practitioner of what's called the Energy Leadership Index. And what that is, it's an assessment that you take, and it's different from personality assessments maybe you've taken, because this is an attitudinal assessment. So it actually shows your energy levels and your attitude that you show up in your normal day, but also under stress and how that might be different. And particularly as you're learning about yourself and you're learning about how you show up, what some of the filters are that you have on the world and that you bring to your day, the Energy Leadership Index is a fascinating tool to be able to use that with coaching. So that's part of my packages as well. I do a minimum of 3 months of time because it's not like you, okay, I'm going to coach for an hour and we've solved all the world's problems. It definitely is a process. So at least 3 months of time, most of my clients end up staying on more of 6, 9, or 12 months.
And that's great. Katie, when I learned about the energy level, energy leadership test, I mean, that blew me away because I think in my experience, most people are tapped in when they're going through a divorce or separation of the immediate feeling, but I don't know if they know what they're bringing long-term to a situation, and I can't imagine how useful that tool would be as people try to assess kind of where they are now and where they want to go. Typically, you know, when someone learns about their energy leadership, I mean, how does that help them in your perspective?
How it works is you have this understanding of how you show up, particularly if you think about a stressful situation and how you react. Okay. We react automatically instead of maybe always having the conscious awareness to choose a response. So especially during difficult times, we might get really angry or we might really shut down. And the assessment tells you all of that, of kind of how you react, both in a normal setting and under stress. And so what it allows you to do is understand that, but then be able to work toward making choices on how you respond, not react. And as a result, you can choose to respond in a way that is more helpful for you, that feels better for you. And over the course of time, you could even take the assessment again after some coaching, and it can change. That's what's kind of cool about it, where a personality assessment stays pretty much the same. This can actually change over the course of time with coaching. And the goal is that the correlation is if your energy level, average energy level rises, it's a very strong correlation with just having higher satisfaction in all areas of your life. And so it's having the awareness of the mindset that you bring every day, and then being able to choose in the moment versus just a normal reaction that might or may not serve you in the moment.
And being able to know that you can choose and where you are is really important if you're trying to set goals for your next steps. So what, in your experience, when do people decide they need a coach? When's a good time to start working with you?
Certainly, any sort of life transitions are a time where we see a lot of people who are interested in coaching. But that's not the only time that it's helpful. So something that's getting past this, either this hurdle, a life transition, a career move, a divorce, some sort of a major change like that. But sometimes it's just feeling like, I just feel a little stuck, and I would like to work on these things, or I have these goals, but I'm not making any progress towards them. You know, if you've ever wanted to write a book for 3 years, but you don't know where to start, or you have things like that that are, you're interested in, but aren't sure where to, how to reach those goals, that's a great way to use coaching. And so I mean, I've seen it, and the power of coaching, I've experienced it myself as a client, and it is so helpful to just adjust your mindset, be able to approach life with a whole different view. And so I'm going to argue that anyone can really benefit from coaching, but we really see clients coming or seeking coaching a lot of times because of a transitional moment or a goal that they're trying to accomplish.
And that kind of, to me, I wanted to segue into talking a little bit about your book. So you wrote a book called Hidden Brilliance. Can you tell me a little bit what that's about?
I did. I just published this year, so it's newly published, and it all started, I actually gave a TEDx talk in September of last year, 2017.
That's awesome.
Thank you. So the book is really an expansion on this topic, and it's part personal story, and then part doing the work. So the personal story is some of my own journey in understanding more about myself and starting a business and learning about what I call the high-achieving introvert. So we don't normally put those together, where people are high-achiever and introverted, because we assume high-achievers are extroverted or, one or the other. And so I always had this experience where I had these big dreams and goals and put a lot of pressure on myself to accomplish them, but I also have, a lot of introspection and a lot of other things that make it very challenging sometimes to live into some of those goals and dreams. And so the book explores that personal story, but then the back half of the book takes you through some activities that are all the things that I did during what I kind of described as my existential crisis.
Uh-huh.
And these were the things that I did to get from point A to point B and really move forward in my life and live bigger, focus on my leadership in a totally different way, and just to find the purpose and the fulfillment in my work and in my life that I was really looking for and was missing. So the book's a really great example of the story, but also gives some practical, tactical things to do within your own experience.
Well, that's awesome. I never thought about a high-achieving introvert, because I agree there is a lot of the idea out there that it's generally the extroverts who are achieving. So it's nice to hear that there's a book kind of coming from the introvert's perspective. I'm part extrovert and part introvert. By the end of the week, I want to just sit down and relax and get back, pull it all back together. So I'll definitely have to check out the book. I know it's on your website. Is there any place else they can purchase it?
Yeah, you can read about it on my website, as well as the TEDx talk is there, and the book is available for purchase on Amazon. So you can buy an ebook or a paperback or a hardcover on Amazon.
Great. So, you know, with you talking about your website, how do people, if they want to move forward with coaching, what's the best way to contact you?
Sure. My website's a great place to start. So that's teamawesomecoaching.com. There's a ton of great information, not just around individual coaching, but some of the work that I do with groups or organizations. The book is there. And I do a lot of writing. So I have a pretty extensive blog on the website. And outside of the website, I'm active on Twitter and Facebook, LinkedIn, and Instagram. Those are all great places to follow if you're looking for new content or just want to see what's new in the world of Team Awesome. And that way you can catch some of the new articles that come out. I do some webinars. I do a lot of different content that might be helpful for your clients.
So if they sign up on your website by giving their name and email, they'll know exactly what you're doing because you're sending out a newsletter that keeps them updated.
I do a lot of social posts, and then every Friday I send out, here's some of the things that are top of mind for me, but it also gives most recent blog posts or information about the book, and it's a great way to stay connected and just see what's going on in the world, and I give a lot of resources, like I always post either podcasts or books that I'm reading or things that I have found that I really liked. So a lot of people really like getting that Friday newsletter. It's really brief, but it gives people some specific resources to go check out for themselves that they might enjoy.
Well, I'm signing up right away so I can get your info. Because I love coaching. I love having someone there to bounce ideas off of. And I'm sure you've got a wealth of knowledge that I can use. Well, Katie, I just want to say thank you for taking time. I think you will be an invaluable resource to our clients, and our clients who are also leaders at work can use you. And I'm hopeful that people will contact you, and thank you for your time today.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
And everyone, thanks for listening. I will see you next time on Sterling TV.